Guys, today I'll be talking about the adaptive autopilots that are used on modern day ships. Now, this is the last video on the series of videos that I've made on the topic of the ship's autopilot that allows the vessel to steer efficiently. You don't have to watch these videos in a series, but I'll advise you to watch all these videos if you want a holistic understanding regarding the topic of ship's autopilot. Simply watching one or two of these videos will not give you the understanding that you require at the level of examinations or certification or even working on board ships as a certified officer. So before I go into the adaptive autopilots, I hope you have seen my other videos regarding PID autopilots and the manual controls and the principle of operation behind an autopilot, and you understand what an autopilot is. So the autopilot systems described so far have operated under various command functions, the origins of which have been small signals produced by the feedback loops. This is especially so in the case of PID autopilots. We have also studied the optimization of the PID controls by the manual operator controls in my previous video. Due to the nature and the working of these manual controls, they do require considerable expertise if the system is to be operating efficiently. So the officer on watch has to be an experienced navigator for the manual operator controls of the PID system to work efficiently. It is not feasible to continually reset the parameters during constantly varying conditions, and thus the system cannot be absolutely efficient in case of a PID autopilot, especially if the officer on watch is not an efficient or an experienced navigator. Because of these problems with the PID controls that used a lot of automatic feedback as well as manual feedback from the following controls that I discussed in the previous video, it was due to the above problems or these problems in mind that in 1970s a research mainly in the field of fluid mechanics and hydrodynamics was undertaken to develop some alternative or improvised system of steering where continually varying weather parameters and their effects can be articulated better and then minimized or eliminated. So what the researchers came up with was something called the adaptive autopilot. The adaptive autopilot basically uses the vessel's hydrodynamic data and the data of the environmental conditions and processes this data and compares it to preset optimal rudder positions. I'll explain it in detail. This is just a brief explanation of what the adaptive autopilot is all about. So how the adaptive autopilot basically works is that the vessel's hydrodynamic data is obtained. So say length, breadth, draft, trim, all these details are obtained other than gross tonnage and net tonnage. All the details of the vessel's hydrodynamic data, which allows the vessel or the stability of the vessel or the steering of the vessel. And then it is fed into a computer program. In that computer software, the vessel is then simulated through a series of courses in different environmental conditions that keeps changing the weather patterns, say wave heights, wind speeds, tide conditions, current conditions, and under those simulations the behavior of the vessel and its steering is observed. Based on those behaviors, the computer software then calculates what is the counter rudder that should be applied in such cases to keep the vessel steering operating efficiently in these conditions. All this is then fed into the software, which is then loaded on with the ship's autopilot onto the ship as well. So in real conditions, when the vessel encounters the different weather conditions, the software already knows what kind of rudder to be put for the vessel to be steering optimally and efficiently. All the officer on watch on the ship's bridge has to do is basically enter the following data: the ship's draft and the total dead weight. So the adaptive autopilot has sensors located all around the ship. These sensors basically sense the weather patterns. So they sense the wave height, they sense the wind, they sense the tide and current conditions, and then feeds data back into the software of the adaptive autopilot. Because the adaptive autopilot software already knows that under certain weather conditions how the vessel will behave and what is the rudder to be applied, the autopilot and the software basically then use the current weather conditions, the information of which is provided from the sensors that are located all around the ship, and then provides automatic response to those weather conditions so that the vessel can then steer automatically or steer rather efficiently. Alright, because the existing the PID system works on reducing the rudder excursions to a minimum and keeps bringing the vessel back to the coastline while keeping the wear on the steering gear to the minimum. What the adaptive system is based on is the study and comparison of the ship's natural yaw action. While the former system, which is the PID system, will keep getting the vessel back on course, the adaptive autopilot system relies on the fact that a straight course to steer is not necessarily the most economical, and that the ship's natural yaw action should not be forcibly smoothed out. Keeping this in mind, it was decided that the steering control should always be optimized with respect to the prevailing environmental conditions, and a dynamically suited low dead band width should be used to minimize the losses. It was obvious now that two main factors which affect the steering control are the complex characteristics of the vessel. The handling parameters for each will be different and will largely depend on the displacement of the vessel, that is the total weight of the vessel, and the underwater hull shape at that displacement. The environmental influences also, including the wind, current, tide, waves, which will be constantly shifting and therefore introducing instantaneous variable course errors. So therefore, the adaptive autopilot system tackles the complex characteristics of handling the vessel as well as the environmental conditions in the following ways to steer the vessel most efficiently. The ship's characteristics are programmed into a standard autopilot system and their effects are counteracted at different settings. There is a digital auto control system which analyzes the data about the dynamics of the ship and its behavior in the existing environment. Having done those comparisons, the computer then produces the final rudder command signals by filtering out the actions of the changing conditions from the vessel's own hydrodynamic behavior. So you can see the control panel here has all this data being fed into the ship's autopilot. All right, so this type of autopilot will have minimal manual operator settings, as with all things involving computer processing. Prior to putting the vessel on the auto steering, some of the ship's parameters like draft, which includes forward draft, aft and midships draft, and minor stability data like the total dead weight will have to be manually input or updated. Most systems have a setting called the tuning or auto tuning, which have also got to be employed initially prior to leaving the vessel on autopilot. These modern autopilots use cutting edge technology to control a ship and are capable of tuning themselves and adapting automatically to the ship's characteristics and the prevailing weather conditions most efficiently. So I hope I provided you with a simple enough explanation of the adaptive autopilot systems. The Kelvin Hughes is one of the types of adaptive autopilot systems. I am not sure what kind of autopilots are available on your ship. It could be a PID autopilots, then you can watch the video on the PID autopilots. Otherwise, if it's the adaptive autopilots, this is pretty much the function here. So the PID control or the PID autopilots use a lot of manual controls as well as automatic feedback. But the adaptive autopilots use minimum manual controls and minimum manual feedback. It mainly uses the software, which is based on the simulations. So if you have any questions or you didn't understand any part of this adaptive autopilot, please let me know in the comment section. I look forward to your feedback regarding my videos and whether they are useful for your learning or not. If they are not, please let me know as well. Happy to improve these videos. If you find these videos useful, please subscribe to these videos as you keep watching them, because then you get notifications of my forthcoming videos. Bye guys, and thank you for watching. All the best with your studies.